I see a market.
I see a market. Tell me more.
From the past.
Describe this market for me.
Kind of like Babylonia. I feel or see that I'm a woman. Very elegant though. Dressed in black, and I feel a lot of gold jewelry.
Do you feel that this is on you?
Yes.
So describe.
But I see her though.
Okay, that's fine.
So I don't see her face because it's covered.
Ah, so describe this jewelry. What does it look like?
Like lots of it, cadenas.
Chains.
And the dress itself has a lot of jewelry too.
Okay, and you say it's black? And she's elegant?
She's respected, but kind of like respected, but fear a little bit.
But feared? So I want you to acclimate yourself into that body. I want you to meld with her body. Feel yourself just becoming one with her. And as you go into her body, you can look out through her eyes. And tell me what it is that you're doing there.
That's where she looked at me. But I'm not able to see through her.
Okay. So you're just watching her.
She has these beautiful brown eyes.
Okay. Very good. So tell me more about her.
She seems to be either the daughter of a high priest or royalty or some kind, but she has powers.
Okay.
She doesn't seem very happy.
Not happy.
Kind of like frustrated that she cannot do what she wants to do.
Tell me what it is that she wants to do.
Heal people, help people.
So tell me more about her. What are you feeling from her?
She has a lot of knowledge. She has a lot of power. But she's frustrated because what I've sensed is that in her lifetime, she cannot do what she wants to do. Because she's a woman.
She's a woman. Okay. Now, as you're observing this woman,
she does it, but it has to be in a cover way.
Okay. Like a secret.
Right. But people know, they sense it. That's why they're kind of like afraid of her. They know she's good, but she knows she's powerful, so they don't want to mess with her.
Ah.
And she has connections.
So, as you're watching her, let's get the sense of what power she has. What do you feel from her?
First, I only see books.
Tell me where you are.
Power?
Where are you?
Kind of like in a, I wouldn't say a castle, but maybe a temple. Something big.
Okay.
And there's a room which not that many people can go, but she can go.
Tell me more about this place. Look around you.
It's mystical. It has stones, books, and some artifacts that I don't recognize.
What do they look like?
They're made of wood. It's like a triangle. Like a compass.
Where is this triangle? Where do you see it?
It's not in the main part of the room. It's like on the side.
So what is happening in this room?
It seems to be her favorite room.
Can you tell if she lives here?
Her.
In this room, in this place.
No.
Mm-hmm.
This is where she studies and she practiced something, but I don't see what yet.
Okay. See if you have any other relevant information from this scene. What else can you gather from it? Look around you.
No, I can't.
Okay. So let's close the scene behind you. Let's close it and let's move to another relevant time in that same lifetime where there's information that will help you. And tell me where you are.
See water splashing, people taking a bath,
mm-hmm.
kids.
Yes.
Actually, they're my children.
Mm-hmm.
That's the feeling I get.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about this place.
It's elegant.
Mm-hmm.
The children seem happy.
Mm-hmm.
They're like two or three of them splashing around. I'm on the side, wanted to be there, but at the same time wanted to go to my room
mm-hmm.
to study.
Mm-hmm. Now, as you're in that place, now tell me how it feels in that body. How does your body feel there?
Good.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
Like 28,
mm-hmm.
30, but frustrated.
Why are you frustrated?
Because I'm not doing what I want to do.
Mm-hmm. And are these your children?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So let's go do what you normally do.
I think that's part of the problem, that I want to be in the room studying and practicing.
Mm-hmm.
Yet I have to attend daily stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That is suspected.
Okay. All right.
And I don't want to do it because it's a waste of time.
All right. So let's close that scene and let's go to your home, the place where you live. Stand in front of it and tell me where you are.
It's strange. It's not as elegant as I would have thought.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what it looks like.
It's like a cabin.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more. Describe it for me.
It's not... I see very rustic. Made of wood.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a big house with not really separation, no rooms.
Mm-hmm. What's the inside look like?
I guess it's big. Close to this fire.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like a cabin.
A cabin.
Mm-hmm. But a big cabin.
Mm-hmm. How many floors does it have?
One.
One.
It's like a big hole.
Okay. And do you see any furniture there?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What does it look like?
Dining room.
Mm-hmm.
Nice chairs. I guess I don't live in the town.
Mm-hmm. What does it look like around your cabin? What's the terrain like?
Green, lush.
Mm-hmm.
Although I get the sensation that it's hot too.
Mm-hmm.
And yellow. Maybe there are seasons.
Mm-hmm. Do you see yellowing of the
mm-hmm.
of the foliage?
And at the soil.
The soil is also yellowed?
And there's, yeah, well, it's part of it.
Mm-hmm. Do you see any animals outside?
Horses.
Okay. What are they used for?
Transportation.
Mm-hmm. Look around and see if you see anything else relevant in that scene. Anything interesting there?
I see my mom briefly.
What's your mom doing there?
She's in the kitchen. I don't talk too much to her.
Tell me why.
She doesn't understand me. She wants me to be more like her. And I don't want to be like her.
Tell me more about your relationship with her.
She's very loving. She's very caring. She doesn't understand me. So we just don't talk too much, so we don't fight.
Who else lives in your house with you?
I feel my kids are there. I don't feel a husband. I don't feel a male presence. I feel a father presence, and I think that's my guide, my teacher.
Your teacher. Does he live there too?
Yes, and I feel he's proud of me.
So let's see who
is. No, he doesn't live here. I think he works in the castle with the. He does something.
Okay. Does he visit you there?
He lives there, but he's usually not there.
Okay. All right.
So that's their houses.
That's their house. Okay. So you just live there. Let's find out how it is that you live there. What is your purpose of living in that cabin? I want you to move to a scene that will explain that.
My husband died. Maybe one of the wars.
How old do you feel there?
Same, like 30.
Tell me more.
I feel I'm pretty and I got suitors, but I don't want to because that would mean that I have to be more of a of what they expect me to be. And I enjoy my studies and my practices. And I know I can help. Because I have powers.
Tell me about these powers.
Energy.
What do you do with the energy?
I transform things.
Like what?
Into better, into vibration.
Is this physical?
My energy, no.
Do you transform things physically or energetically?
I think both. Harder to do it physically, but I can do it physically too. I'm learning how to do it.
What would they call your profession or what you do?
I'm not sure because as a woman, you're not supposed to do it.
Ah, okay.
But my dad is taking a risk because he knows that I have the power and the gift.
And he allows you to study?
With him.
With him.
In that room.
So your father is the one who has the powers and teaching you?
Yes.
Okay.
But I came with them too. He's proud of me.
You're born with them.
My mom didn't agree. She loves me.
Is she afraid of something?
Yes.
Tell
Society.
Me.
That they may hurt me. That's why when I walk on the street, in the market, people look at me with fear.
What would they do to you if they found you practicing this?
It depends. I'm not afraid because my sense is that my father has a job with the king or the powers to be. And I am protected because the love that they have to my father and how helpful he is. And they know that I'm like him.
Do they respect you? But it's the common people that don't respect you?
Because they don't understand me.
Yeah, are they afraid of you then?
Yeah, the way I dress, the way I don't talk to many people. They don't see my faces. I'm dressed in black and jewelry, so they know I'm important.
Okay. So, is this how the royalty dresses?
No, I think more the priest.
The priest? As a priestess.
It's a combination.
Tell me about that.
like I'm not supposed to be a priest, so the jewelry distracts from the fact that I'm wearing priest clothes.
Okay. And how do the priests dress, the males?
I see black.
Mm-hmm. Is this a long dress that you wear?
Mm-hmm.
Do the males also wear a long robe?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay.
Do you wear anything on your head?
Yes.
What do you wear?
Same cloth as the dress.
Mm-hmm.
And it has a golden gold enema, a circular thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a nun's wear, but it's black and it has a gold, in order to be in my head, it's a gold, I don't know how you call it.
Is it like a headband?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Very rich, very elegant.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a crown.
Like a crown.
But not a crown.
Mm-hmm. Does it have any design on it?
Geometrical.
Mm-hmm.
It means something.
Mm-hmm. Does it have any crystals on it? Any stones?
I sense crystals, but I don't see them. I only see gold.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything on your third eye?
A dot.
A dot. Mm-hmm. What does that dot signify?
To have access to it.
Mm-hmm. Did you already always have that dot?
No, it was a ceremony.
Mm-hmm.
It was an important one.
Mm-hmm. How old were you then?
18.
Okay.
It came very easy for me.
Did it? Tell me about that.
I mean, my gifts.
Mm-hmm.
Since I was a kid, my father was proud of me.
He was proud of you?
There was a lot of fights.
Mm-hmm.
Because my mom didn't want that. But one of my father's peers also encouraged him to teach me, even though it was not accepted in society.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because I had strong gifts.
Wonderful. So let's close that scene now. Let's move to another important day in that same lifetime. Let's move forward. Tell me where you are.
Seems that I'm working with the powers that be. I think he's a king.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of hard because it's not one person. It feels like it's a set of people.
A set of people who
rule? Like a council, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like wise men.
Mm-hmm. How many are there?
I sense 7.
Mm-hmm. Where are you? Are you inside or outside?
I'm in the temple, the castle.
Yes.
And I'm talking to them. I'm older now.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
Like 50.
Mm-hmm.
It feels like I'm at the end of my life for some reason.
Mm-hmm. So tell me the conversation that you're having with these men.
There's an issue. I don't know what the issue is, though. I cannot hear it.
Okay.
But there's some concern.
All right. Let's connect. Let's connect with these men telepathically. I want you to use your third eye and just connect with these men, and you'll be able to hear the conversation in your mind.
Oh, talking about a possible war.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't like wars, and I don't like to advise on wars.
Tell me more about this.
They're asking me to use some of my power for their benefit, to avoid the war.
Mm-hmm.
But that's difficult because you cannot control free will.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to the dark side.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to do it. But if I don't, it's going to be a lot of bloodshed.
A lot of bloodshed. Mm-hmm.
So I'm having a very difficult time deciding what to do.
What did they tell you?
They're pressuring me, but I feel they're tricking me.
What do they say?
For me to use my powers to control the enemy. I don't want to do it because that goes against my teachings. Mm-hmm. Once you do it, they will expect you to do it again and again. And even though they're wise men, they still have egos.
Mm-hmm.
And they may use it against others for their own benefit.
Mm-hmm.
So I need to know what to do on my own.
What role do you play with these men?
Kind of advisor,
mm-hmm.
and also energy and future. I can see the future.
Okay, so you can see the future. Mm-hmm. Are you able to see the future as to when you use your energy or not? Can you see the outcome?
Yes.
What do you see?
I see a lot of blood.
Mm-hmm. So tell me what happens next.
I didn't let them persuade me.
Mm-hmm.
But I knew that could be dangerous for me. And that was, I mean, it was dangerous for me.
What happened?
I lost their protection. So it was very dangerous for me.
Mm-hmm.
But I know I did the right thing. And I went into hiding.
So tell me where you are now in hiding.
Small town. It's with one of my daughters.
Mm-hmm.
With my son, and maybe both of them. I see them both.
Mm-hmm.
I have another son, but I think he's dead or something because I don't feel him.
Mm-hmm.
They love me very much. Even though I feel guilty because I was not a conventional mother.
Mm-hmm.
And they are the ones who are protecting me now.
How do they protect you?
Giving me shelter. Giving me another identity.
Mm-hmm.
Very thankful, but I'm also frustrated because I cannot really practice. I do help people now and then. Sometimes they don't even know I'm helping them. But it has to be very careful. Mm-hmm. Because
they'll find out.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. How are you dressed now?
Brown clothes, normal clothes, or like an old lady's clothes.
Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
I'm okay. I'm at peace.
Mm-hmm.
I was a little tired of everything that was going on before. It was too much pressure.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't like the fact that we were not moving into a loving direction. We were moving into a fear direction.
Mm-hmm.
And there was very little I could do to stop it.
Okay. So now close that scene behind you. Let's move on and see what happens in that lifetime.
I die peacefully.
Okay. Tell me what's happening.
I'm laying in bed.
Mm-hmm.
I see my daughter next to me. Lots of love.
Mm-hmm.
I feel guilty about it for some reason.
Okay, tell me the thoughts that are going through your head.
I'm grateful and guilty.
Mm-hmm.
Because I didn't realize that even though I was giving so much love, helping to the energies and my powers,
mm-hmm.
that I felt I neglected my kids.
Mm-hmm.
But as an adult, they're actually were proud of me and they had so much love back to me. So I don't know why I feel a little bit guilty.
Mm-hmm. So what is it that you're dying of? Look in your body and see.
I don't know where the word pancreas came to mind.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So do you feel like you're sick with your pancreas?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Take your last breath now. And as you leave that body, I want you to look back at that life. Every life has a lesson and a purpose. As you look back at that life, what was the purpose of you having it?
Some of her frustration reminds me of what I'm going through right now.
Mm-hmm. Well, I want to talk to that personality. What does the personality say? What is her
most frustration?
Mm-hmm.
I sense two things, that she couldn't do everything that she wanted to do and explore because she had to be contrived by society and and be in hiding, which precluded her to do all that she could have done to improve things in one hand. On the other hand, that's the frustration keeps coming up.
Okay. All right. So I want you to follow her all the way as she leaves her body and tell me what's happening with her spirit. Where does she go?
Sense confusion at the beginning, but then she goes to some sort of council. It's kind of like a very important one.
Okay, so like let's
send the masters.
So let's listen into what's going on there. I want you to find yourself there and tell me what it is that's going on with her council. Who's with her?
I see white robes.
White robes.
I feel many more male energies.
Many male energies.
Some female, but more male. I think one of them could be her father. And they're going through her life and things that she learned and things that she missed.
So tell me what it is that she's watching.
Kind of hard to describe because it's not like a human form. It's more like energy, like light.
What are the mistakes she made?
She was a perfectionist. And she always wanted to know more. And more and more. Which sometimes precluded her for her to perform. And she was frustrated how unfair society was. Especially with women, because she knew that it didn't have to be the way it was. Instinctively.
Yeah. Focus in and see what was the purpose of that lifetime. What was she supposed to learn?
She was supposed to learn not to use her powers with love, not with ego.
Okay.
And the masters are telling her that she did a great job, that she had many decisions, including the one that we spoke about. And that she did not do a mistake.
So she served her purpose well.
She didn't let the ego. Apparently, that's why she wanted. She was a woman. So she'd be stronger in that sense.
And why did she come to be that person with all those powers? Why does she choose to come?
To help. But also sense to explore, to be creative, to see how it felt to be in that third dimension, and to have so much going against you, but at the same time learning little by little with the help of her dad to regain those powers that she already had.
Good. Are you looking at the council from far away, or are you right there?
I'm right there.
Okay. So I'd like you now to acclimate yourself to that place. And I want you to ask that council, what was the purpose of Marcio coming into his life?
I'm supposed to use my powers. I already have the training, so I don't let my ego get in the way. So I don't need to worry about that.
So ask them, what are the powers that Marcio is supposed to use in this lifetime in order to help people?
I get energy, but I don't get more.
Energy work? Ask him to tell you more about the life and the purpose of Marcio.
Everything happened for a reason. The fact that I didn't have a happy childhood. The fact that I had so much going against me. Yet, it was a great combination of pain, sorrow, obstacles, and at the same time, I came from a wealthy family, didn't face any enduring issues. Even the war, I was a child, so it didn't affect me as much. So I was able to understand duality and understand suffering, to be more empathic, because if not, if my life would have been great, I would have not been able to understand other people.
Why did you choose that family?
I knew the circumstances. I knew that there's going to be a lot of suffering. But I knew it was not really evil. It was just lessons that I needed to learn.
Is anybody from the lifetime of this priestess in the same life of Marcio now?
I would like my dad to be, but I don't see him. I miss my dad. His somewhere though, his master that I need to find. When I find him, I'll know.
Good.
It'll be a hair.
Good.
It's gonna be a strong connection. It hasn't happened yet.
All right. So let's leave the council there unless they have some more information. Ask them if they have more information for you.
We laugh, they always say the same thing. That I'm doing a great job.
Wonderful. So let's close that scene. We're drifting away from that scene. I know that the higher self could have shown many different lifetimes for Marcio to see today. And you chose to bring forth the priestess. What did you show him that?
Be more connected with female energy, and to understand all the power that he has, and don't go through the same frustration that she did, because then she was not completely happy. And living on Earth because she was always concentrating on something else that was missing.
Ah. Would you tell me where that was, that lifetime?
Babylon.
Babylon. What year was it?
493.
493. That's a long time ago. And T has questions about his life now. We already asked the masters one thing, but he wants to know what gift or instruments that he's supposed to rediscover in order to help people.
That could be energy.
Mm-hmm. In any particular form? Is it Reiki or hypnosis or generational healing, yoga? What should he be doing?
I just feel my hands.
Mm-hmm. In the hands. So he should work something like in Reiki or reconnective healing?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Everything will come into place. He wants to know everything right away.
He does.
And he can't, little by little.
Mm-hmm. He's trying to drink out of a fire hydrant.
But he gets bored easily, so that's why.
Mm-hmm.
You need to be slow.
Mm-hmm. So what are you working on him right now? What are you trying to teach him at this moment?
His fear. Mm-hmm. To let go.
How can he let go of all these fears that he has?
He's doing a good job.
Mm-hmm.
Going to the roots.
Mm-hmm.
Self-esteem seems to be the one that he's not working as much.
Mm-hmm.
But he needs to look into it.
Now I know that the higher self can rewire things in people's minds. Can you work on his self-esteem with him?
Sure.
Mm-hmm. And continue working at night while he's sleeping?
Yes.
Thank you.
He knows it.
Mm-hmm. What else does he need to do to fight these fears so that he can get into this higher vibration?
Remember that he's light.
He's light. Mm-hmm.
And none of this is real.
It's all an illusion.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. He understands that.
Yes, in the concept, but not really completely.
Mm-hmm. How can you give him some more tips to help him with that?
In due time.
Okay, good. What entities are working with him?
Archangels.
Mm-hmm. Anyone in particular?
Michael.
Mm-hmm.
Azrael.
Mm-hmm.
Raphael. And Uriel.
Okay. And do they have different functions for him?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Are these his guides, or does he also have his own personal guide?
He has a big guardian angel.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, a few of them.
A few of them. And they're all working with him?
With the archangels.
Mm-hmm. Are there any here today that would like to tell him anything? Give him a message.
No.
No?
Don't sense it.
Don't sense it, okay. Has he ever had any ET contacts?
I want to say yes, but nothing else comes to mind.
Okay, good. I want Marcio to move out of the way and allow the higher self to...
Because he's very happy and eager about this answer.
Mm-hmm. I know. Tell him to move over. I think he wants to have contact. What about relatives that have crossed over? Are there any of them?
I see a ship.
Mm-hmm. You do see a ship. Where do you see the ship?
Like I am on it.
Okay. Would it be beneficial for you to explore this? I'd like to ask the higher self.
He wants to know, and he knows, but he's not ready yet.
Okay, so we don't want to show him that right now?
Not yet. Okay. He will come.
All right.
Tell him not to worry.
Okay, I will. What about relatives that have passed over?
Yes, they're working with him.
Mm-hmm. Who are they in particular?
Most of them.
Most of them?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
His grandparents?
They're working with the family, mm-hmm. mostly. He's not the only one. But his vibration is getting highest the fastest, so they're communicating with him a lot more.
Mm-hmm. How can he improve that connection with them?
Learn Buddhism,
mm-hmm.
and do more meditations.
How often do you want him to meditate?
Twice.
Twice a day? For how long?
As long as he needs, at least, but maybe an hour.
Okay.
There's a lot of information that's going to come. Not only information, but open up cracks for his powers.
Okay. Are they downloading that to him?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can he sense when they're downloading information?
Now he can.
Okay. What does he feel?
Tingling.
Mm-hmm.
Or specific body parts being worked.
Mm-hmm. Is there any healing going on?
Yes.
Okay. He had told me before we started the session that he felt something in his knee. What was that? Was that you working on him or something else?
Yes.
What's going on with the knee?
It's like it's where most of the energy comes in.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Why did you choose the knee? I would have thought it would have been one of the chakras.
Everybody's different.
Mm.
In his case, I hear temporary.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of energy coming to the knees.
Okay, but that shouldn't last long.
No.
Okay, good. He's been reading a lot of Dolores Cannon books. And he wants to know if he's a second wave.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell him about that?
There was a reason that the information came to him
mm-hmm.
at the right time at the right place.
Mm-hmm.
He sensed it. He knew it since he was a kid.
Mm-hmm.
I was observing, always feeling like he was from somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
He always liked to study.
Where is he from?
Not ready yet.
He's not ready. What about his family members? Are they also all these first, second, or third waivers?
Some of them are.
Mm-hmm. In general, just asking about sex for curiosity, when someone approaches the topic of sex spiritually, how should you think about it?
Like anything. Depends on the person.
Mm-hmm.
For some people, it may be a distraction,
mm-hmm.
not necessary, or even dangerous. And for some people, it could be the missing link.
Mm-hmm. Double connect them. Mm-hmm.
Society makes so much about sex.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a normal function.
Yeah. Should he be doing automatic writing?
Yes.
Is that a gift that he has already?
Yes.
Okay, so he needs to have a clear head in order to do that.
Yeah.
All right.
He wants to do channeling.
Mm-hmm.
But he doesn't put himself in the right vibration for it.
Mm-hmm. Now, I've been told myself to not drink alcohol or consume anything like that while I'm doing this work. How does that affect while you're channeling?
Alcohol?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's not good.
Mm-hmm.
And Marcy has to be careful because of his liver.
Okay, what's going on with his liver?
Too much, too many medications before.
Okay.
He knows that already.
Mm-hmm. Okay. How can he open his third eye?
Practice more.
Mm-hmm. What does he need to visualize?
The third eye is already open.
Okay.
He just don't know how to use it.
So how can he practice?
Meditation.
Okay.
And Buddhism.
And Buddhism. Okay, good.
And also his father is going to come. Not his real father, but mm-hmm. from the other lives.
Mm-hmm.
His master, you could say.
Yes.
It's going to be very important for him.
Mm-hmm.
This person is going to take him under his or her arm and teach him a lot. And the perfect knowledge that he needed.
And he's gonna help him with all the spiritual practices?
Yes.
Okay, because he was asking which direction he should go in.
Because they worked together before. Ah. They make a good team.
Okay. And it is male? A male?
No, I'm getting neutral. I don't know.
Okay, good. Good. He had listed.
Older.
Older, okay. Okay, like a teacher?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He had listed some holistic practices, Reiki, crystals, shaman, card reading, nutrition, new Germanic medicine, hypnosis, transgenerational healing, and yoga. He wants to know which one he should be focused on.
He will never be happy with just one.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to know everything.
Mm-hmm.
Because he already knows everything.
So what would you suggest? Should we do all of it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Don't stop. Just do it.
Okay.
Whatever you learn will be useful.
Okay. He had asked me about Dolores Cannon's quantum healing hypnosis. Is this the direction he should go into?
He could.
Mm-hmm.
It will be hard for him.
Okay. Tell me why.
Self-esteem.
Okay.
And perfectionist.
Mm-hmm.
So if patients do not react, he will take it personally.
Okay.
And then the flow may not be good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Too much emphasis on trying to help the other person. If the other person doesn't help, he takes it personal.
Okay. He also asked about patience. He says he doesn't have the patience that he needs.
He does.
Mm-hmm.
Just confused. He has a hard time keeping his attention focused.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that, he thinks that he lacks patience. That's not the case.
What's causing that lack of focus?
It's like a little kid.
Mm-hmm.
He's here on Earth and he wants to learn everything.
Mm-hmm.
But he wants to learn through books, not through living.
Ah, it's harder.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of funny. Because he's like right now living on Earth and he just wants to read about it.
Now, you said he was a second waver. Where was he before? Because you showed him this life as a priestess. Where was this life?
And the priestess?
Mm-hmm. You said Babylonia. Was it this earth or was it a different earth?
That's this earth.
Okay.
But he has many lives, okay. Not only here.
Mm-hmm. Where else is he living?
Not important right now.
Okay. All right.
He's too fascinated by it, with it. And it's going to get sidetracked.
Okay. So just focus on this life?
Yes, on his abilities.
Mm-hmm. Would you do a body scan on him and tell me what you find?
Liver.
Mm-hmm.
Detox.
Can you work on the liver now? We'll clear that up. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The liver is like a filter for the body, and if you can clean out the filter for him.
Well, we're working with him.
Mm-hmm. Good. Can you put some extra energy in today? And just so that he has it on the recording, what are you using?
Blue energy.
Blue, okay.
We also send him to the doctor.
Mm-hmm. You're sending him to the doctor?
The audio doctor.
Okay, tell him about that. What are you finding?
His liver was going to suffer from the medicine, HIV medicine.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to stop it. He didn't want to do it. But little by little, we got him to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And then we asked him to meet this doctor.
Mm-hmm.
She's from the Pleiadians.
Mm-hmm. The Pleiadians?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And she is healing him through sound too, in addition to what we do.
Okay.
But it was important for him because he needed a doctor figure.
Mm.
And he'll be okay.
Is he doing the right thing about stopping that medication that he's been taking for so long?
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
His liver was being compromised.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Does he need to focus on the what they said he had?
Not really.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually going to go away.
Okay. Can you work on him today and do some extra healing so that we can advance that?
Sure.
Mm-hmm. And tell him what you're using.
Orange, red light.
Okay. Tell me when you're done with that light.
Yeah.
Good. What else have you found in his body that needs tending to?
His body is very healthy.
Mm-hmm.
He's not listening to us in terms of more physical exercise.
Physical exercise. What would you like him to be doing more of?
Yoga.
Yoga, okay.
He likes to do weights, and that's okay too.
Mm-hmm. How does the yoga benefit him?
Number one, taking away from reading his books. But more important, not only is the physical connection, but also his mind.
Mm-hmm.
It will help him. Another form of meditation, which he needs. He needs more meditation.
Okay.
He's good at it and he knows about it, but he gets bored.
Mm-hmm.
Because he likes to learn.
Yeah.
But there's a lot more knowledge coming his way.
Mm-hmm.
Through meditation.
Okay. So you're going to be downloading that information instead of through books.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But he's impatient.
How much longer does he have to wait for this information?
It's coming soon.
Okay. Within this year?
Yes.
Okay.
Lots of energy going on.
Mm-hmm. How is that energy going to affect his body physically?
He's well prepared.
He is.
You already went through.
Mm-hmm. Is his kundalini awakened?
Yes.
Okay, good. So his third eye and kundalini are now open. What about his chakras? How are they doing?
There's some alignments that needs to be done.
Mm-hmm. Which one?
He has concentrated mostly on his upper chakras.
Mm-hmm.
He has paid little attention to his lower chakras.
Why is that?
Because he feels that the higher the chakras, the more intuition and the more spiritual powers it will have.
Mm-hmm.
And it's neglecting the basics.
Okay.
So he needs to go back to the basics.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Which one needs to be aligned today?
I see yellow.
Okay.
And red.
Mm-hmm. So the two lower ones. Would you align them for him today?
Sure.
Thank you. Tell him when you're done.
Done.
Good. Thank you very much. How does his aura look?
The colors?
Mm-hmm. How does it look? I mean, is it healthy? Does he have any leaks in the aura?
It's healthy.
It's healthy. Good.
He's a strong soul.
He is. Okay. Talking about his body, is there anything that he should be eating or avoid eating?
He's doing a good job there.
Okay.
He's been listening,
mm-hmm.
and he's been doing the baby step changes that he needs to make.
Okay.
So there's a lot more changes coming up. But he's doing it.
Mm-hmm. Good. Would you scan his body and see if there's any implants in his either his physical or etheric or astral body? Any of the bodies that he has?
The knee came out again.
The knee. Is there an implant in the knee?
Yes.
Okay.
A major one.
Okay.
That's probably why the energy is there.
Okay. Tell him about that implant. Who put that there?
His family.
Mm-hmm.
Astral family?
His astral family? Mm-hmm. Who are they?
They're ETs. Mm-hmm. Advanced
mm-hmm.
ETs.
Mm-hmm. Are these benevolent?
Yes.
Okay. And what does the implant do for him?
Give him the extra energy that he needs right now
mm-hmm.
to change the molecules and the DNA of his body.
Okay.
Although most of the heavy stuff already happened.
Okay.
That's why he kept waking up in the morning and the middle of the night with sweats.
Were they taking him also?
Yes.
Okay.
He does not remember.
He doesn't.
He knows about it. He knows, but he doesn't remember, and that's not important right now.
It's not. Okay. Will he ever be able to see these?
Yes.
His family. Okay. Is that coming soon?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good.
Through meditation.
Through meditation. Okay. What was the reason that you brought Marcio here today? You could have taken him to anybody else.
Energy match.
Mm-hmm. What did you want to tell him?
Practice, practice, practice.
Mm-hmm. So what would you like to tell him? What else would you like to tell him besides practice?
That is a powerful being.
Mm-hmm.
Full of light and he has a mission and everything so far has been going great for his mission
mm-hmm.
to be accomplished.
Mm-hmm. Great.
To thank him. We know it has not been easy.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for volunteering.
Thank you very much. Now, I know that you've been speaking to Marcio through him for a long time, and he may go home thinking he's been answering his own questions. Can you tell him who or what you are? In your own words, can you describe yourself?
I'm his higher self.
Mm-hmm.
Not so much advanced than he is, just that I have more knowledge of what it is to be in different dimensions, working together as one, as we are. That is also very good at multiple dimensions. But right now, that's not a gift that he has, because it will be too confusing. And that's why he loves quantum things, quantum physics and quantum, because that's just one of his expertise.
And on the spirit side?
Yes.
And his astral self?
He's very good at it. He loves it. That's why he gets bored with just one thing.
What does he do at night when he leaves his body here? Where does he, what's his job when he goes to sleep?
There's a lot of communication exchange. What's going on Earth and the plants, the event.
Can you tell him a little bit about this event and the ascension?
He volunteered to help Earth move into a third, from a third to a fifth dimension.
What's his role? I've heard some people just are here to emit their energy. Does he have anything that he needs to do?
His role was just to be a beacon of light.
Okay.
That's not enough for him. He wants to do more.
Okay.
And it's okay that he does that because he likes to be creative and explore. But just let him know that just being here and doing what he's doing his job.
Okay.
So whatever else he does is extra.
Okay.
And he's appreciated.
Very good. Very good. Who are the ones who are watching him or guiding him? Is it the archangels, or does he have a council that's actually watching him?
He's very well connected. The most important one is the forum, the counselors. That's the one that give him feedback. Also his soul family. From the ET race.
Okay.
Which I'm not going to tell him right now.
Okay.
And guardian angels.
How many does he have?
3, 4.
Do they switch depending on what he's doing? Okay.
Sometimes they work in tangent.
Okay. Who's working with him today?
Two of them.
Do they have names?
Not important.
Okay, not important. Good.
Marcy will start doing research.
Okay, good. That gives him some fuel to.
And we don't want that. No more books.
No more books. Okay. Is there anybody here that would like to communicate with Marcio today besides the higher self?
Lola,
okay.
She's not able to communicate with him as much.
Okay.
Because of vibration issues.
Ah.
She's wanting to send a message of love. And to know that she's there and that we'll be communicating soon.
Wonderful. Thank you. Is there anything else? Are we complete today?
We're complete. Marcy needs to do more homework in terms of what I've been asking him to do, which he has done, but he could do better. In terms of meditation, stay in touch with nature.
Ground himself.
Exercises, yoga, Qigong, energy. Qigong will be good for him too.
Good. Wonderful. Thank you very much. Welcome back, Marcio.
Okay, I have questions. Most of this information I already knew. So how do you know when...
Because you've been in connection with your higher self. You've been in contact with your higher self all this time.
I mean, I didn't know about the past like that. I never knew. That was beautiful. But she was
Wasn't
not
it?
happy, though. She was frustrated.
She was frustrated because she couldn't do what she could. She was a woman and in a man's
But
world.
the beautiful thing is that she was put into the test and she did the lesson,
Yes.
which is she didn't let her ego, because that would have been easier for her. She could have been like the priestess.
Right.
And they get all the power.
She was pretty humble.
But she decided to do the right thing.
Yeah.
And then she had to go back to her family
mm-hmm.
and live a very humble life because
yes.
of her decision to do love instead of fear.
Mm-hmm. So how did this differ with other hypnosis sessions? How do you feel?
Well, this was more profound.
Mm-hmm.
And the weird thing is when you start at the end, when you start calling me,
mm-hmm.
that's when I went more like before I was conscious.
Oh, you're a busybody, that's why. Because yeah. You didn't want to lose control. You're hanging in there for every word.
Yeah, because I was so curious.
when I was counting you out, it's like, oh, I don't need to listen anymore.
And when you're asking the hard questions, that's when I was like,
what's he going to say? What's he going to
yeah,
say?
Like I couldn't answer my dad. I don't know why.
So did you feel that you got your answers?
I was frustrated that I didn't want to say too much about my ET life. I mean, he confirmed it, but he didn't, I guess.
It's not where he wants you to go right now.
I guess.
I think the fact that you're going to start going
reading
about it,
books.
And that's, it's like, you're not there yet. We don't want you.
So he confirmed it. He confirmed about the second wave.
Yes.
And he confirmed that I'm a beacon of light, just
yes.
so I'm, I passed the test already, which is nice to know that, and it's okay for me to look into
all of these practices.
Yeah.
And he said, you're never going to be satisfied with
yeah.
any one.
Because
you're like a kid in a candy store.
Exactly.
It's like, I want this and that.
And that was the lady too. That's why she was so happy in the library or the study
she
of his dad. The books and the knowledge.
And then you could see that's the life that you're picking from her. That's the life you most associate with. Because she loved her books and she loved her energy work. How long do you feel like you were in this trance?
Like 40 minutes?
An hour and 20 minutes is what I have on the clock.
What? That's strange. That's the usual, that's what you ask, because usually people think that it's a lot shorter.
Some people get it, but if you're deep in, it feels like just like that. So you feel good? You recommend this to other people?
Yes.
And you felt Dolores at the beginning, before
yeah.
you even started.
That was very nice.
Yeah. How does she feel to you?
Like a mother figure, like a, but a scientist in a way.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. That's how you felt her.
Yes, yeah, it's a weird combination.
You could see that you're really, your powers are really getting strong. And your kundalini has already awakened, your third eye is open.
But I don't see it. I mean, I had a dream,
mm-hmm.
and in that dream, all of a sudden, I saw like a movie, and it was like a different planet.
Yeah.
And when I woke up, I was like, this was a lucid dream to let me know that my eye was open, but mm-hmm. then how do I... And I hear people that see blue and
Everybody's
purple,
different.
And I don't see anything.
Everybody's different. But for you, you have to practice is what you're
And what I hear is voices. That comes easier to me.
Mm-hmm. So you're clairaudient.
And that's what I think. I need to do more writing. But
yeah.
when I smoke at night, it's difficult because then I have dread meditation. But afterwards, I just want to watch TV or fall asleep.
Exactly. So is this something you recommend to other people?
Yes.
And would you share this?
Yes.
Want to share this? We want to pull some parts out?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. Well, thank you very much. That was great. Let me unhook you.
I mean, I was hoping it was going to be more exciting, to be honest. but then, like you said, I think I'm very connected.
All right, so let me say goodbye. My name is Alba Weinman. We're having a session here in Miami, Florida. And if you would like to book a session with me, just go to albaweinman.com to get more information. And we'll see each other again soon. Thank you. Bye.